Hello everyone, this is Rachelle Ann Go. I play Fantine in Les Miserables.
And I'm Peter Lockyer. I play Jean Valjean in Les Miserables.
Oh, well, performing as a solo artist is totally different than performing with the other great artists on stage, especially in West End. Yes, I'm part of West End now. I'm performing now with like a brilliant actor, so now I need to check my acting skills, if I'm on the right track, if I'm on the right blocking. I need to give the right emotion that the actors around me are giving me. So basically it's not just me. I can't riff also, I can't ruin what Alain Boublil and Claude Michel wrote in this musical, but yeah, basically I just need to stick on what the director told me to do and feel all the emotions around me.
You know, I did see a few things early on when I was about 12, 11 and 12. I saw the very first live production I saw was at the Metropolitan Opera House in New York. I saw Luciano Pavarotti and Kathleen Battle do L'Elysée d'Amour. And I just was so blown away by Pavarotti's presence and sound, and it was mind-blowing for me. So there was that. I saw a chorus line very early, and I could not believe how amazing that was, and the dancing and just the beautiful women on stage. That's for me. No. But I think also when I graduated high school, I think I lived near to New York City. I was only 2 hours away. And I thought, you know, why not just give it a go? And if it doesn't work out, I can do something else later on. So luckily, knock on wood, so far, it's okay.
What helps me? Oh, well, I do pray every single night, no fail.
Can you pray for me too?
I will do that.
Okay, thank you.
And you will always see me in one corner, like internalizing. And good thing I read the book that Victor Hugo wrote. And I read Fantine's bit, and I fully understood what she went through, the heartache, the despair, the sadness, the loneliness, and in a way, I can relate to her. Yeah, part of my story, my past. Yeah,
of course. So, of course.
Which is really good, because yeah, every single night, it's just helped me to really be in the character.
This role in particular, I'm incredibly lucky to play for a period of time, more than just a couple weeks or something like that, because it's the kind of thing you could do your whole life and learn from. I feel like I learn to be a better man by playing Valjean. You know, Valjean is constantly seeking answers in how can he be a better man, how can he answer his morals and the ethics of life in a way when the world is constantly presenting challenges. So to play that story every day and then to think about how, you know, I can be a better friend or a better husband or a better person to someone on the street it's incredibly moving to me. So I think I could do it for another few lifetimes and continue to learn.
A lot of dream roles in mind, but I'd like to try Eponine one day, and maybe go green one day.
You'd be fierce. You'd be fierce. Wicked.
Yeah.
You want her. Yes.
Put it out there.
Amazing. You'd be amazing.
Yeah. Who knows? Yeah. One day.
Okay, I have a lot of favorites, you know, from classics like Carousel, West Side Story, Fiddler on the Roof, things like that. But and I'm not just saying that because I'm in it. Les Mis is my favorite all-time musical. It's
Wow. It's
by far the best thing going. I mean, it's epic. The story is phenomenal. Like I said earlier, that being able to play this character is so I feel so incredibly fortunate to do it that I pinch myself every day, no matter how long I've done the show. Mm-hmm. It is my favorite, mm-hmm. truthfully.
Well, to be honest, I never expected to be in this, you know, big production in a musical. When I saw like musicals before, I was like, I can't do that. That's too hard for me, you know. I'm not good enough. I feel like I'm not good enough before. And unless you try it, you can't say you can't do it. So for me, it needs a lot of sacrifice though. It'll take lots of time, lots of hours to rehearse and to hone your craft also. And it's really a hard work. So you gotta have the passion and you have to believe in yourself that you can do it. Yeah.
What about in Tagalog?
Huh? Kayanyan.
I think the advice I'll give is that the best actors I've ever known are the smartest people in life. So I feel like you can't ultimately hide completely who you are on stage. Mm. So if you're going to play various people, you're doing yourself a great favor by learning as much as you can about other things in life. And so I think a very strong liberal arts education is important.
Yeah.
Even if you're not formally in school, read every book you can get your hands on, because you're going to play various people and you can't play them if you don't understand them. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lauren!